And now, beloved, I would like to take this moment to acknowledge and to share how eternally grateful I am that the Reverend Brooks Graebner has been our priest in charge while Imogen was on parental leave. He has been a source of insight and just a fountain of knowledge in so many areas. And so I give thanks to his ministry. I give thanks to his presence among us. And I pray that sometime in the future, he will come back and worship with us and preach and celebrate.
Good morning and welcome to the Church of the Good Shepherd in Raleigh, North Carolina. My name is Brooks Graebner, and today marks the end of my time as priest in charge. This week, the rector, Imogen Rhodenhiser, returns from her parental leave, during which she has been caring for her newborn son, Wilfred. And I know everyone here at the Church of the Good Shepherd joins me in welcoming Imogen and rejoicing in Wilfred's birth. Today also marks the first Sunday in the season of Lent, a 40-day period of preparation for Holy Week and Easter, when we will mark the passion, crucifixion, and glorious resurrection of our Savior, Jesus Christ. On the first Sunday in Lent, it is customary to begin our worship by praying the Great Litany. The Great Litany is the oldest and most extensive set of prayers in our prayer book. It is also customary to chant them, and that's what we'll be doing at this service. In the Great Litany, we ask God to deliver us from all those things which might do us harm, and we beseech God to keep and hold us fast. We also offer prayers on behalf of our world, our community, and ourselves. Joining me in the leadership of this service is our associate rector, Mother Joyce Cunningham, members of our choir, and members of our youth group. And now, let us prepare our hearts and minds for worship and join our cantors in praying the Great Litany.
Charity. Good Lord, in your heart. us
from all inordinate and sinful affections, and from all the deceits of the world, the flesh, and the devil.
But why deliver us
from all false doctrine, heresy, and schism, from hardness of heart and contempt of thy word and commandment?
But why deliver us
from lightning and tempest, from earthquake, fire, and flood, from plague, pestilence, and famine?
But why deliver us
from all oppression, conspiracy, and rebellion, from violence, battle, and murder, and from dying suddenly and unprepared?
But why deliver us
by the mystery of thy holy incarnation, by thy holy nativity and submission to the law, by thy baptism, fasting, and temptation?
But why deliver us
by thine agony and bloody sweat, by thy cross and passion, by thy death and burial, by thy glorious resurrection and ascension, and by the coming of the Holy Ghost?
Good Lord, deliver us
in all time of our tribulation, in all time of our prosperity, in the hour of death, and in the day of judgment.
Good Lord, deliver us.
We sinners do beseech thee to hear us, O Lord God, and that it may please thee to rule and govern thy holy church universal in the right way.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord,
that it may please thee to illumine our bishops, priests, and deacons with true knowledge and understanding of thy word, and that both by their preaching and living they may set it forth and show it accordingly.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord,
that it may please thee to bless and keep all thy people.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord,
that it may please thee to send forth laborers into thy harvest, and to draw all mankind into thy kingdom.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord,
that it may please thee to give all people increase of grace to hear and receive thy word, and to bring forth the fruits of the Spirit.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord,
that it may please thee to bring into the way of truth all such as have erred and are deceived.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord,
that it may please thee to give us a heart to love and fear thee, and diligently to live after thy commandments.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord,
that it may please thee so to rule the hearts of thy servants, the President of the United States, and all others in authority, that they may do justice and love mercy and walk in the ways of truth.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord,
that it may please thee to make wars to cease in all the world, and to give to all nations unity, peace, and concord, and to bestow freedom upon all peoples.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord,
that it may please thee to show thy pity upon all prisoners and captives, the homeless and the hungry, and all who are desolate and oppressed.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
Let it may please thee to give and preserve to our use the bountiful fruits of the earth, so that in due time all may enjoy them.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
Let it may please thee to inspire us in our several callings to do the work which thou givest us to do with singleness of heart as thy servants, and for the common good.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord. We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to preserve and provide for all women in childbirth, young children and orphans, the widowed and all whose homes are broken or torn by strife.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to visit the lonely, to strengthen all who suffer in mind, body, and spirit, and to comfort with thy presence those who are failing and infirm.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to support, help, and comfort all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to have mercy upon all mankind.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to give us true repentance, to forgive us all our sins, negligences, and ignorances, and to endue us with the grace of thy Holy Spirit to amend our lives according to thy holy word.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and to turn their hearts.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
Strengthen such as to stand, to comfort and help the weak-hearted, to raise up those who fall, and finally to lead down Satan under our feet.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to grant to all faithful departed eternal life and peace.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
Let it may please thee to grant that, in the fellowship of all the saints, we may attain to thy heavenly kingdom.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
Son of God, we beseech thee to hear us.
Son of God, we beseech thee to hear us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
grant us thy peace.
O Christ, hear us.
O Christ, hear us.
Lord, have mercy upon us, Lord, have mercy upon us.
Let us pray. Almighty God, whose blessed Son was led by the Spirit to be tempted of Satan, make speed to help thy servants who are assaulted by manifold temptations. And as thou knowest their several infirmities, let each one find thee mighty to save. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Then God said to Noah and to his sons with him, I now establish my covenant with you and with your descendants after you, and with every living creature that was with you, the birds, the livestock, and all the wild animals, all those that came out of the ark with you, every living creature on earth. I establish my covenant with you. Never again will all life be destroyed by the waters of the flood. Never again will there be a flood to destroy the earth. And God said, this is the sign of the covenant I am making between me and you and every living creature with you, a covenant for all generations to come. I have set my rainbow in the clouds, and it will be the sign of the covenant between me and the earth. Whenever I bring clouds over the earth and a rainbow appears in the clouds, I will remember my covenant between me and you and all living creatures of every kind. Never again will the waters become a flood to destroy all life. Whenever the rainbow appears in the clouds, I will see it and remember the everlasting covenant between God and all living creatures of every kind on earth. So God said to Noah, this is the sign of the covenant I have established between me and all life on earth.
Psalm 25, verses 1 through 12. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. My God, I put my trust in you. Let me not be humiliated, nor let my enemies triumph over me. Let none who look to you be put to shame. Let the treacherous be disappointed in their schemes. Show me your ways, O Lord, and teach me your paths. Lead me in your truth and teach me, for you are the God of my salvation. In you have I trusted all the day long. Remember, O Lord, your compassion and love, for they are from everlasting. Remember not the sins of my youth and my transgressions. Remember me according to your love, and for the sake of your goodness, O Lord. Gracious and upright is the Lord, therefore he teaches sinners in his way. He guides the humble in doing right, and teaches his way to the lowly. All the paths of the Lord are love and faithfulness to those who keep his covenant and his testimonies. For your name's sake, O Lord, forgive my sin, for it is great. Who are they who fear the Lord? He will teach them the way that they should choose. They shall live in prosperity, and their offspring shall inherit the land. A reading from 1 Peter. For Christ also suffered once for sins, the righteous for the unrighteous, to bring you to God. He was put to death in the body, but made alive in the spirit. After being made alive, he went and made proclamation to the imprisoned spirits, to those who were disobedient long ago, when God waited patiently in the days of Noah while the ark was being built. In it, only a few people, eight in all, were saved through water. And this water symbolizes baptism that now saves you also. Not the removal of dirt from the body, but the pledge of a clear conscience toward God. It saves you by the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at God's right hand with angels, authorities, and powers in submission to him. The word of the Lord.
Thou wast for us Reading from the Gospel according to Mark. At that time, Jesus came from Nazareth in Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. Just as Jesus was coming up out of the water, he saw heaven being torn open and the Spirit descending on him like a dove. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, whom I love. With you I am well pleased." At once the Spirit sent him out into the wilderness. And he was in the wilderness for 40 days, being tempted by Satan. He was with the wild animals, and angels tended to him. After John was put in prison, Jesus went into Galilee, proclaiming the good news of God. "The time has come," he said. "The kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe the good news."
May the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be always acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. When I consider what has transpired over the past 3 months, as my time as priest in charge comes to a close, I know that I will, from this point on, ever associate the Church of the Good Shepherd with reading and discussing C.S. Lewis's The Screwtape Letters. I'm so glad Imogen suggested we do it. The discussions the last 3 Sundays have been lively and thought-provoking. Now, it seems especially fitting to mention that today, since the subject of temptation is always foremost on this particular Sunday of the church year, the first Sunday in the season of Lent. Every year we read one of the accounts of Jesus' temptations in the wilderness, and we pray that God will help us withstand the assaults of our own temptations. Now, the Screwtape Letters are all about temptation. What tempts us, why it tempts us, and how it leads us away from God. In letter number 25, Lewis tackles the lure of novelty and what he terms the horror of the same old thing. Lewis suggests that God has placed in our lives a lovely conjoining of change and permanence through the natural rhythms of the 4 seasons and through the spiritual rhythms of the liturgical year. As one season leads to another, we experience its return anew, and we delight in it afresh. But then we mess up a good thing by demanding novelty, unrhythmical change, unnecessary change, change for the sake of change. And when novelty wears off, we want more novelty, but with diminishing enjoyment. Now, Lewis has a point, and there are years when a sermon about slowing down and savoring the slower, time-tested rhythms of natural and liturgical life might be just the thing. But this year, the challenge takes a different form. We've been living through what my friend and colleague Clark French calls the season of COVID-tide for almost a year now. And if you're like me, you're getting restless and impatient with all the constraints and constrictions. It's not novelty I seek. I am longing to return to the accustomed rhythms and rituals of my life. I've improvised for way too long. But that is its own form of temptation. My longing for something I can't have right now takes my focus away from appreciating what I do have, the beauty, the grace, the love that still surrounds me if I only stop to savor it. That came home to me with particular force on Monday evening. After a long day of Zoom meetings, I opened my emails, and there was a link to the video file of the psalm being read by Cecelia Nobles with Grant Carpenter's guitar accompaniment, and the text of the psalm imposed on the background image of the altar and the Good Shepherd window. You've just had a chance to see it for yourself in today's worship. Now, as I watched and listened for the first time on Monday night, the cares and concerns and petty frustrations of the day melted away in the face of radiant beauty and grace. In writing the Screwtape Letters in 1941, C.S. Lewis wanted to remind his fellow Englishmen that their lives mattered, that their commitments to one another mattered. He didn't want the distractions and disruptions of World War II to diminish the surpassing value of their decency and their devotion. What Cecelia and Grant have given us, what the love and encouragement they have received from Tara Lloyd and Wayne Holiday has brought forth in them, what the intrinsic beauty of the psalm and the sanctuary have provided them, these can't be measured, but they can be received and cherished and held close in our hearts and minds and spirits. Let us not be tempted to regard the present time merely as a burden, but also to appreciate its blessings. Even in this very service, even in the midst of COVID-tide, may this holy season of Lent continue to bring you renewal and rest. Amen.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, victorious, mighty and free, teach me, O glorious,
And now, beloved, please join me as I pray the prayer for spiritual communion. Let us lift up our hearts in praise and thanks to God, creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who was tempted in every way as we are, yet did not sin. By his grace, we are able to triumph over every evil and to live no longer for ourselves alone, but for him who died for us and rose again. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. In union, O Lord, with the faithful at every altar of your church, where the Holy Eucharist is now being celebrated, we desire to offer you praise and thanksgiving. We present to you our souls and bodies with the earnest wish that we may always be united to you. And since we cannot now receive you sacramentally, we beseech you to come spiritually into our hearts. We unite ourselves with you and embrace you with all the love of our souls. Let nothing ever separate us from you. May we live in you, and may you live in us, both in this life and in the life to come.
Amen. Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory
forever and ever.
Amen.
God of wilderness and water, your Son was baptized and tempted as we are. Guide us through this season that we may not avoid struggle, but open ourselves to blessing through the cleansing depths of repentance and the heart-rendering words of the Spirit Amen. Most merciful Lord, to your faithful people, pardon and peace, that they may be cleansed from all their sins and serve you with a quiet mind through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
So, my sisters and brothers, go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.